there, it's Lauren Messiah, your personal fashion stylist, and we are in the last video of the Climbing the Style Ladder, Dress Your Way to the Top series. What a mouthful that is. Yes. So we've made it from the job interview all the way to today's video, which is the corner office. The corner office. I mean, does that even like really exist anymore? There's so many high positions that have said, I made it, and it doesn't necessarily have to be in some big corner office. It can really be anywhere. It can even be a state of mind. But when you've reached the top, if there is such a thing as the top, how do you dress? Are you to the point where you're like, psh, I'm the boss, I can do whatever I want and I can wear whatever I want? Or do you take the responsibility of making it very seriously, understanding what your new position means to you, and do you dress accordingly? Well, that's my hope, and that's what this video is really all about. It's about taking your success and understanding the power that that holds and the responsibility to keep dressing the part and showing that you're a role model, that you're someone people can aspire to be, someone who can be led underneath you. So I want you guys to get that in check. So when you have made it to the top, I want you to dress to impress and to dress for respect at all times. And trust me, it's not easy. I will admit there are some days where I come to work and I'm like, really, Lauren, this is the best you could freaking do? And then I sit there having a meeting with my team and I'm like, geez, like these are people who show up every day and give their best work to work for me. The least I can do is show them what it means to be a business owner, to be a woman who is living out her dream, doing the best, putting food on my table and theirs. So you really want to be seen in a light where people can trust you as a leader and respect you as a person and be proud to work for you. So when you're getting dressed every morning, it's no longer just about you, it's about the people that you work with. If you are outward facing in your company, on social media or on TV, you're representing not only yourself, but your entire company. So making sure that you are taking that seriously and really dressing the part is key. Now this is gonna vary from industry to industry, job to job. So it's hard to say, once you've made it to the top, you need to always wear a power suit and Christian Louboutin heels and a Prada bag. The formula is very personal to you. It really just applies to what you do for a living and who you are inside and the message that you want to convey to the world. I tell you, my employees will think I'm freaking crazy if I start showing up in suits every day. They're gonna be like, wait, what? What happened? Do I need to wear suits every day? No, we have a very casual, creative work environment. But if I'm showing up in sweats and my hair not brushed and looking crazy, then they're not gonna wanna follow me as a leader. It's gonna be harder for me to lead as well when I'm not really feeling on top. So whatever professional means to me and to my business is what I will show up with and what I will wear. So think further than your own comfort. Think about respect. Think about what the next level is for you. I say the top because where is the top? Sure, you're in the corner office, you're the CEO, you're the president, you are whatever it seems that the top is, but there's always more to go. There's always more goals to set, there's always more goals to achieve. So what's the next best thing? Okay, now I have the corner office, I run this amazing corporation, what's next? Is it writing a book? Is it being on TV? Is it starting a nonprofit? Is it doing more volunteer work and being a leader there? What does that look like? And what is the uniform that you want to show up in? So continue to set those style goals for yourself and continue to make sure that your appearance is of top priority. Because I'm telling you, and I've said it in so many other videos before, once one thing starts slipping, it's usually a reflection of something else that's not on point, or it's just part of a slippery slope where other things are gonna start falling apart too. You want everything to be really lined up and even. You know, your appearance is on point with your level of success. Your level of success is on point. It means, you know, is your family life on point? Everything should be very even, and you can use these different things as a barometer of how you're doing. So if you're showing up every day in some like uninspired looks, some dirty clothes, something in your life ain't working out right. So let's get all of that stuff in check so everything can move up together. So there is no top. It's philosophical style Lauren in the house. Okay, so that's that. That's the end of the series. Just wanted to give you a little further inspiration to continue to dress your best as you climb up through your career, kick ass, do your thing, and share your successes with other people, particularly me. Put it in the comments section. Let me know how dressing for success has affected you in the workplace. And let me know, I love it when you guys leave comments about how you've actually applied some of the things that I say in these videos and what happens to you. I love it when I get comments like that. So let me know if you've had any shift in perspective on style in the workplace, and spill it, share. I love it. Cool. So do that, and while you're down there, hit that red subscribe button so you are subscribed to my channel and all tuned in. There are also style freebies at the bottom of every video. It could be a free ebook, it could be a free checklist. They're all resources to help you kick ass in life and with your style. So scoop them up, get them for free, get your subscribe on, and I will catch you in the next video.